Dear students, welcome you all to EPG Pathsala. I am Dr. S. Gandhimathi, Associate Professor, Department of Economics, Avinash Lingam Institute for Home Science and Higher Education for Women, Coimbatore. In this module, we are going to discuss about the use of chi-square test and method of estimation. Introduction. Chi-square test is one of a non-parametric test to test the goodness of fit and to verify the distribution of observed data with assumed theoretical distribution, chi-square test is used. Therefore, it is a measure to study the divergence of actual and expected frequencies. It has great use in statistics, specifically in sampling studies, where we expect a doubtful coincidence between actual and expected frequencies and the extent to which the difference can be ignored because of fluctuations in sampling. If there is no difference between the actual and expected frequencies, chi-square is zero. Thus, the chi-square test shows the discrepancy between theory and observation. Objectives. In this module, we are going to discuss the following: the characteristics of chi-square test, assumption of chi-square test, uses of chi-square test, how to apply chi-square test. First, characteristics of chi-square test. It is specifically used to test the association between the variables when the data is qualitative. Then second one is, chi-square test is based on events or frequencies, whereas in theoretical distribution, the test is based on mean and standard deviation. To draw inferences, it is applied to test the hypothesis. Then fourth one, the test can be used between the entire set of observed and expected frequencies. Then fifth one, a new chi-square distribution is formed for every increase in the number of degrees of freedom. Assumption. Let us discuss the assumptions of chi-square distribution. The observations must be independent. Then second one is, the events must be mutually exclusive. Then third one is, there must be large observations. And then fourth one is, the data must be in original units for comparison purpose. The fifth one is, the expected frequencies should not be less than 5. If it is less than 5, it should be pooled within the frequency from the adjacent item. Then sixth one is, the sample data must be drawn at random basis. Then degrees of freedom. When we compare the computed value of chi-square with the table value, the degree of freedom is evident. The degree of freedom means the number of classes to which values can be assigned at will without violating restrictions. For example, we choose any four numbers whose total is 50. Here we have a choice to select any three numbers, say 10, 15, 20, and the fourth number is 5. And thus, our choice of freedom is reduced by 1 on the condition that the total be 50. Therefore, the restriction placed on the freedom is 1 and degree of freedom is 3. As the restrictions increase, the freedom is reduced. Thus, degrees of freedom nu is equal to n minus k, that is, nu is equal to degrees of freedom, k is equal to number of independent constraints, k is equal to number of frequency classes for a contingency table, 2 into 2 table, the degree of freedom is nu is equal to c minus 1 into r minus 1, that is equal to 2 minus 1 into 2 minus 1 equal to 1. Then let us discuss what are the uses of chi-square test. Chi-square test of goodness of fit. The first use of chi-square is to test the goodness of fit. Though the test we can find out the deviations between the observed values and expected values, here we are not concerned with the parameters but concerned with the form of distribution. Carl Pearson has developed a method to test the difference between the theoretical value and the observed value. The test is done by comparing the computed value with the table value of chi-square for the desired degree of freedom. A Greek letter chi-squared is used to describe the magnitude of difference between the fact and theory. The chi-squared may be defined as chi-squared is equal to sigma observed minus expected frequencies the whole square divided by e. O is equal to observed frequencies, e is equal to expected frequencies in the given formula. Then let us discuss what are the steps in the chi-squared test. First one is, a hypothesis is established along with the significance level. Second one is, compute deviations between observed value and expected value. Then third one is, square the deviations calculated, that is observed minus expected frequency the whole square. divide the observed minus expected frequency, the whole squared by its expected frequency. Then add all the values obtained in step 4 and then find the value of chi square from chi square table at certain level of significance, usually 5% level. If the calculated value of chi squared is greater than the table value of chi squared at certain level of significance, we reject the hypothesis. If the computed value of chi squared value is 0, then the observed value and expected value completely coincide. If the computed value of chi squared is less than the table value at a certain degree level of significance, it is said to be non-significant. This implies that the discrepancy between the observed and expected frequencies may be due to fluctuations in simple sampling. Then the following example will clear the. For example, coins were tossed 160 times and the following results were obtained. Under the assumption that coins are balanced, find the expected frequency of getting 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4 hits and test the goodness of it for the above data. Solution: hypothesis is that coins are unbiased. When x is equal to 0, expected frequency is equal to 10. When x is equal to 1, the expected frequency is equal to 40. When x is equal to 2, the expected frequency is equal to 60. When x is equal to 3, the expected frequency is equal to 40. When x is equal to 4, the expected frequency is 10. When applying chi squared, the expected frequency and observed frequencies are listed in the first, second, the observed and expected frequencies are listed in the second and third column, and then in the next column, the deviations of observed and expected frequencies is calculated and then it is squared. Finally, the sigma observed minus expected frequency the whole squared by E is equal to 12.725. That is, the observed minus expected frequency the whole squared by E is equal to 12.725. That is, calculated chi squared value is equal to 12.725 and the table chi squared value is equal to 9.488. It indicates that the calculated chi squared value is greater than the table value and therefore the fit is insignificant. The second use of chi squared is chi squared as a test of independence. Chi squared test can be used to find out whether one or more attributes are associated or not. For example, coaching classes and successful candidate, marriage and failure, etc. We can find out whether they are related or independent. We take a hypothesis that the attributes are independent. If the calculated value of chi squared is less than the table value at a certain level of significance, the hypothesis is correct and vice versa. The following example will clear. For example, out of sample of 120 persons in a village, 80 were administered a new drug for preventing influenza, and out of them 26 persons were attacked by influenza. Out of those who are not administered the new drug, 6 persons were not affected by influenza. So question number A, prepare 2 into 2 tables showing the actual and expected frequencies. Then question number B, use chi-square test for finding out whether the new drug is effective or not. Then solution, the expected frequencies is calculated and is given in the table. Then let us influence on new drug be independent. The expected frequencies are calculated and are given in the table. Then in the next table, observed and expected frequencies are listed and the deviation of observed minus expected frequencies the whole squared is listed and it is divided by expected frequency is also listed. So the calculated chi squared value is equal to 35.7, whereas the table t value is equal to 3.84. Hence, calculated value of chi squared is 35.7, which is much higher than the table value. Therefore, the hypothesis is rejected. Hence, we conclude that the drug is undoubtedly effective in controlling the influenza. Then, x correction. If any cell frequency in 2 into 2 table is less than 5, then for the application of chi squared test, it has to be pooled with the preceding or succeeding frequency so that total is greater than 5. This result in the loss of 1 degree of freedom in such a condition, that is, when any cell frequency in 2 by 2 table is less than 5, we apply the correction, popularly known as Eight's correction, for continuity. This consists in adding 0.5 to the cell frequency which is less than 5 and adjusting the remaining frequencies accordingly, since row and column totals are fixed, and then applying chi squared test without pooling. The following example will clear the Eight's correction. solution aids corrections are applied solution sorry the following example will clear the aids correction. In aids correction, 0.5 is added to the observed cell frequency, which is less than 5. In this problem, an observed frequency is less than 5. As such, we will add 0.5 to 2 and make it 2.5. The rest of the frequencies are adjusted, keeping subtables unchanged. Thus, after aids correction, the observed frequencies would be as follows. Now, we can calculate the value of chi squared with the above observed frequencies. Then calculation of chi square value. So in the following table, the observed and expected frequencies are listed and the chi square values is calculated as 1.68750. Since this value is less than the value of chi square, it is not significant. The vaccine is not effective in controlling the disease. That is the conclusion. Then third use of chi square is chi square as a test of homogeneity. This type of application of chi-square test can be recorded as an extension of the chi-square test of independence. Such tests indicate whether two or more independent samples are drawn from the same population or from different populations. Instead of one sample, as we use with independence problem, we shall now have two or more samples. A random sample is drawn from each of the population and the number in each sample falling into each category is determined. The sample data is displayed in a contingency table. The analytical procedure is the same as that discussed for test of independence. The main difference is that in test of independence, we are concerned with the problem whether the two attributes are independent or not, while in test of homogeneity, we are concerned with whether the different samples come from the same population. Another difference is that test of independence involves a single sample, but test of homogeneity involves two or more samples, one from each population. Then additive property. One of the merits of chi-square test as an instrument of research is that it is possible to combine the independently derived values of chi-square relating to samples of similar data by the simple process of addition. It enables a better test than could be made using the data of any one sample by itself. The sum of the chi-square values thus combined will itself have a chi-square distribution with the degrees of freedom equal to the sum of the degrees of freedom of the separate chi-square values. However, while adding chi-square values, two points must be remembered. The combined result in a single inclusive test is appropriate when the samples are independent. When chi-square values are to be added, aids correction should not be applied because the addition theorem holds only for uncorrected constituent items. The following example will clear. In the example, 1000 families were selected at random in a city to test the belief that high-income families usually send their children to public schools and the low-income families send their children to government schools. The following results were obtained. Here we are going to test whether income and type of schooling are independent. Solution. Let us take the hypothesis that the income and type of schooling are independent. Then expectation of AB is equal to A into B divided by N. That is equal to 500 into 800 by 1000 equal to 400. The table of expected frequencies is given in the following table. Applying chi-square test, the observed minus expected frequencies and its square is calculated and therefore the calculated chi-square value is equal to 22.50. The calculated value of chi-square is more than the table value, that is mu is equal to 1, chi-square is equal to 0.05 equal to 3.84. Therefore, the hypothesis is rejected, hence income and type of schooling are not independent. Example. From the data given below about the treatment of 250 patients suffering from a disease, state whether the new treatment is superior to the conventional treatment. The data is given. Solution. Let us take the hypothesis that there is no significant difference between the new and conventional treatment. Apply the chi-square test. Then the chi-square test is applied. The expected frequency is calculated. So the table shows the observed and expected frequencies and the deviation of observed and expected frequencies and the square of observed and expected frequencies. And finally, we have the chi-squared value, that is sigma O minus E the whole square divided by E. So the calculated chi-squared value is greater than the table value. Therefore, the hypothesis is rejected. Hence, there is a significant difference between the new and conventional treatment. Let us summarize. Chi-square test is a non-parametric test. It means that it is not based on any distributional assumption. The chi-square test is used to test the independence of attributes and to test the goodness of fit and to test the homogeneity of samples. Chi-square test is based on frequencies and it is not based on the actual values. When the data are categorical and qualitative in nature, we cannot apply any parametric test because the parametric tests are based on distributional assumptions. In such cases, we have to compulsorily use the non-parametric test. But it is not the meaning that chi-square test can be applied only for the data of qualitative in nature. Even if the data are in actual values, we can convert the data into categorical and can use the chi-square test. Hence, the chi-square test can be used in the place of parametric test also. But parametric test would not be used in the place of non-parametric test of chi-square.